Empath, the survival guide for highly sensitive people. Protect yourself from narcissists and toxic relationships. Discover how to stop absorbing other people's pain, plus 30-day challenge. Written by David Clark. Narrated by Rebecca Cade. Introduction. There is a unique breed of individuals who are gifted with the ability to not only experience their emotions and those of the people around them, they can also experience the physical pain of other people. These individuals walk into a room, and within minutes, they can accurately pick on the vibes of the people in the room. This may sound like a cool superpower that belongs on the set of X-Men, but in reality, it is something that can be very difficult to deal with. Not many people are emotionally and mentally equipped to manage these gifts. You may identify such persons as people who are overly sensitive. Psychology experts profile them as empaths, and their story is not always one of those happily ever after types. For the longest time, emotions have been frowned on as a weakness, and displaying them was described as a feminine trait at best. In worst-case scenarios, people who showed their emotions one too many times were regarded as persons who have no control over how they feel. Derogatory terms like unpredictable, walking eggshells, crybaby, and so many other names that are not fit to print are used to tag people who dare show their emotions. The general negative perception about emotions has woven itself into the very foundation of society, which is the family. There are a lot of families today who enforce strict measures to deter any display of emotions at home. This need to shut down a very crucial aspect of oneself has led many to suffer silently for a better part of their lives. For an empath, they live with the double trauma of dealing with their own emotions as well as the pain of others. This leaves them constantly emotionally overwhelmed. If you picked up this book, chances are you are an empath, or you know an empath who struggles with their emotional burden. But what if I told you that those very emotions that you feel cripple you in your ability to thrive could be channeled into making you a better version of yourself, and in so doing, you can enrich your life? Sounds too good to be true, right? Well, there is one truth that many of us have heard, but don't really believe because they've been dumped in the same category as those ineffective life cliches people dish out. Your emotions are anything but weak. In fact, it is described as one of the most powerful forces possessed by humans, and before we go any further in this book, I can tell you that shutting down your emotions is not going to do you any good. The only way forward is to embrace those feelings by choosing to accept your abilities as an empath. Being an empath goes beyond understanding your emotions. As an empath, you embrace the emotions of others. The wealth of understanding you acquire in this process gifts you with a unique perspective of the world and the people that you encounter daily. This goes a long way to help you foster relationships that are more meaningful and impactful. Most importantly, as an empath, you develop a deeper connection with yourself that truly empowers you to understand pain. This is not some new age psychobabble fad that is trending at the moment. This is you taking back the power from people who have tagged the way you truly feel as weak and evolving into the real you that you are meant to be. With this book, you can finally take off the mask you have been forced to wear by the society and step into your reality. As an empath who had to navigate the process of my becoming without a guide, I know how difficult to make sense of how to feel. I spent lots of hours daily scouring through the internet for information on these rainbows of emotion that I go through every day. I've come close to several breakdowns, not because I had a lot of bad experiences or that I was taking on more workload than I normally would. I was just constantly overwhelmed by what I was feeling. People would come to me with their problems because I had a knack for being such a great listener and I could connect with them in ways that they found comforting. However, I also ended up having to deal with the emotional aftermath of their predicaments. I sought counseling, and for a while that helped me, but I still sought validation from the people I deal with on a day-to-day basis. I didn't want to crumble emotionally in front of them so that I could keep being their go-to counselor. This meant I had to act like I had my life together 100% of the time, even if in reality, it felt like I could barely keep the seams from falling apart. In very second terms, I was a mess. With the contents of this book, I was able to make sense of the emotions I was feeling, find the strength to embrace these seemingly chaotic parts of myself, learn to manage my emotions better, unlock my natural intuitive nature and pay more attention to my instincts, and become better at managing my relationships with people. Maybe you are reading my story and feeling like you are looking into the mirror of your own life. Here's an assurance. If I can find my way back, so can you. However, there is a caveat. Living as an empath requires you being deliberate about your decisions. Anything less could send you on a downward spiral to a dark place that not many people recover from. Before you flip over to the next chapter, I want you to take a moment and decide right here, right now, that you are going to be more deliberate about the choices that you make going forward. That said, the information you would receive in this book are practical steps you can take daily to help you better manage your emotions while navigating the murky emotional waters of other people. At the end of this book, you should be able to stand on a rooftop and proudly declare that you know who you are. That knowledge is powerful and very uplifting. So, to begin the next chapter of your life, turn over to the next page. Things are about to get exciting. Chapter 1. Are you an empath? I was a teenager when I had my first encounter with the word empath. It was from a television series that was popular at the time. In this series, the empath was portrayed as someone who is gifted with divine powers and the ability to feel everything the people around them felt. This empath could feel their pain, their joy, their anger, and even their fears. In this fictional world, the powers of the empath were transferable, but if anyone other than a true empath attempted to take these powers, they would be crushed by the weight of the emotions they were forced to experience. This interpretation of an empath is certainly fascinating, but it is also very extreme. Sci-fi lovers share a similar view with the creators of this fantasy series. Culturally, empaths are believed to be humans who possess this paranormal ability to accurately sense the emotional state of others. A popular empath in today's sci-fi trend would be Mantis from the movie Guardians of the Galaxy. Again, this is all very cool, but reality tells us a different story. What is an empath? An empath is simply a person with a heightened awareness of the emotions around them. Beyond this awareness, empaths tend to show a lot of empathy towards other people, so much that they can experience the emotions of others as if they were their own. Empaths don't just observe people, they have the innate ability to experience them from the inside. The term ability is used loosely here. It does not connote the existence of supernatural traits. Rather, it is directed as a personality trait that uniquely defines them. In psychology, empaths are described as people who have a great amount of empathy for others. Given everything I've explained so far, it might feel a little disappointing to see empaths defined with such simplicity. Empaths are powerfully unique because they can sense emotions that the people around them try to hide. Without the right information, however, this uniqueness can cause a lot of frustration. That said, how can you tell if you are truly an empath and not simply projecting what you hope you are? I've compiled a list that explores the characteristics of most empaths. If you relate to 6 or more of the following traits, you are likely an empath. 10 signs you're an empath. Number 1. Crowded spaces cause you to feel overwhelmed. When you are in a sea of people, their emotions wash over you like waves. For a person who has a tendency to feel everything, it can leave you feeling overwhelmed. The sensation is akin to experiencing sensory overload, where all of your senses are firing off in different directions. Number 2. You personalize the experience of others. When a friend comes to you with stories that have strong emotional content, you don't just listen and try to gauge their current state of mind. You see yourself walking in their shoes and reliving their experiences as if they happened to you. At the end of this conversation, you are not just an observer, but an active participant in the event. This leaves you just as emotionally riled up as the person who shared their experience.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.